Hello everyone, in this video we'll be setting up multi-sites for our Drupal website. Multi-sites are basically when we use the same code base and use it to install and develop two different sites. So we can do that using the multi-site feature, and in this video we'll be talking about how to do that. So let's head over to our C panel. And let's get started with the job. So for us to use that, so let's log into cPanel and then head over to our public HTML directory from our file manager, and over here we'll be starting with the installation. So for installing Drupal, we of course need a let's remove this from here. We of course need Drupal files. We can download that from over here, drupal.org/download, and we'll be downloading this zip file, and then we'll be uploading that over here in our cPanel. So let's do that. Let's upload a file. Sorry, not going to create a file, we need to upload a file. So let's upload the zip file from downloads and Drupal from tab user. So yeah, Drupal 8.4.3.tar.gz. So this is gonna upload, and then we'll head back to our main directory and extract it. Let's go back to our directory. So as you can see, I have my file over here. Now what I did was, when I downloaded the zip file, I opened it in my extraction manager, and I renamed the files to be extracted to Drupal 8. So now when I extract this, I'm gonna see a Drupal 8 file over here. Not Drupal dash 8, Drupal 8, so that it does not confuse with this. So let's extract this. Let's extract our files. And alright, our Drupal 8 site has been extracted. Drupal 8 has been extracted. We will now go into our Drupal 8 directory, and we'll be modifying some things. So we'll be going to our sites, and we'll be telling Drupal that okay, we want two sites over here. So to do that, we need to create a sites.php file, and we need to write some pieces of code over here. So we need to find a template from that. We'll be using that using from the example.site.php. We'll go over there, and you notice that this is what we need to tell Drupal. We need to create an array of sites, and this is how we're gonna do that. So we have to start with the $sites is equal to array, and then give a port name, and then name of the site, and then point it to a folder or something. So let's do that. Let's create a file over here, and let's name it sites.php. And alright, so let's open this in our code editor, and let's code it php and sites. Sorry, our sites is equal to array, and we want it to be Tanvish is dot me, that was my domain name, / Drupal 1. So hang on a second, I should not be, I don't know why these are still here. This is because of some domain problems. So I don't think it deletes itself, it automatically loads itself again. So when I click on refresh, so I think we're gonna go with Drupal.1 only. So this is the URL that we'll be entering, and this will point to Drupal 1. So this is what the folder would be. We'll be creating the folder in a while. So we want another site, then which is me dot Drupal 2, and this will be pointing to Drupal 2. Alright, so let me just change this slash to dot, because that is under template, and let's close this, and let's close this as well. So we have a file created. We have tanvishes.me.drupal1, and then tanvishes.me.drupal2, which will point to these two folders. Let's save these changes, and I think we are done over here. So when I go to my Drupal 8 and when I go to sites, I should be able to see the sites.php. alright, so we have done that successfully. We will now go to default, and we will copy these two files into the new two folders that we'll be creating in a while, which will be named Drupal 1 and Drupal 2. So we'll be doing that using SSH, and let me just set that up. Server 47.webhosting.com, and let's just hope this works. This should be working. If it's not, then that might be an issue. Let's try again. Server 47.web-hosting.com. I think we just need to connect our hosting to our SSH, and then we got to go. So it took some time to set up, because it took a lot of time to load. That was the reason it wasn't showing up. So now that we have our SSH set up, let's move to our public underscore HTML directory. Let's move to our Drupal 8. Let's move to our sites, and let's see what files are there. So we have readme.txt and all development and all that. So let's create a directory over here, Drupal 1. Let's create a directory Drupal 2. Let's copy the files we wanted, which was in default.settings.php to our new site Drupal1/settings.php. You might have noticed we removed the default prefix, because we don't want that. Now we are actually copying a file into our new site, and it has to be a settings.php. It is not supposed to be a default file. We'll do the same for our Drupal 2 site. And now we'll copy the services.yml file. So services.yml, and services.yml, and I think we could over here. Let's also copy this for a second. So we must have created two directories by now. I'll just move from over here only, cd drupal 1 and ls. So you will notice there are two files that have been created, and if you go to cd drupal 2, and do an ls, we'll notice that there are two files created already. So we are good over here. Let's go to our Drupal directory. So let's go back from our sites to our main public underscore html directory. Let's just go back to main and then go from here to public underscore html. And from here, let's create a symbolic linking that will link the same code base to two different sites. So we can do that using ln dash symbolic linking, and then we need to copy the Drupal 8 files, alright? So Drupal 8 files into our Drupal 1 and into our Drupal 2. So now when we do an ls, we'll be able to see our two sites over here, Drupal 1 and Drupal 2. And I think we have done the job over here. Let's go to tanvishisme/drupal1 and we have the session page. So just so you know, when I go to public HTML directory, I can see that my two symbolic linkings have been done over here. And see, this is Drupal 8. So yeah, as you can see over here, if you go to tanvishisme/drupal8, I don't think tanvishisme/drupal8, you'll be taken up to installation page, but we don't want that right now. We want to install Drupal site 1 and Drupal site 2. So okay, we have the two languages over here. Let's choose English, let's choose save and continue standard installation. Let's have a standard installation. Let's continue anyway. We'll be using SQLite in this. We can use databases also. I have created the databases already, but SQLite is more faster, and we don't have to type in the passwords and all. So let's save and continue, and let's use SQLite over here also and save and continue. And I think we are good to go now. We'll wait for them to install the sites. This might take a bit of time, so I'm just gonna pause the video now and come back to you after the installation has been created. So now we are at the end of our installation. For our Drupal site 1, let's name it Drupal 1 and let's give it any email address as of now. Doesn't really matter. Let's give it a password and let's give it another password, confirm the password, and let's save and continue. Let's give this a site of Drupal 2 and let's give it a password as well, and let's save and continue. And now we should be able to see our two sites. So we have our Drupal 1. I want to save this, and we should be able to see our Drupal site 2 as well. So this is Drupal 1 and this is the Drupal 2. We can refresh the page over here, and this is Drupal 1. We'll refresh the page over here, and we have our two sites. So okay guys, that is how you can create any number of sites using just similar code base, and within a matter of few minutes you can have multiple sites. Thank you guys for watching.